Plaintiff Vita Peaks says the defendant is her daughter, and she's the biggest drama queen Vita knows. Vita claims she loaned the defendant money for a dental procedure, but she failed to repay her, so she's suing. Defendant Kenyetta Peaks says her mom has tried everything to fight off aging. Kenyetta claims Vita tries to dress and act like her, and even tries to steal her friends. Kenyetta admits that she borrowed money for dental work, but insists her mother is trying to get more money for Botox.
Start with you.
All right, first of all, a little bit about me. I'm a mother of three children. I have four grandchildren. And I've always been taught, well, I was raised by my grandmother, and she always had taught me that, you know, when raising children, it's imperative that you lead by example. And to the best of my ability, this is what I did. And I will say, yes, there are times growing up, I was very much a drama queen. I was very dramatic and everything. It is my time to speak, and when Judge Mathis.
Hold it up, hold it back. Hold it back. You know you say you're a drama queen.
She's always got to be the center of attention of everything, and everything is an emergency. When I tell you, drama queen, there is no one in Hollywood have anything on this one. And Judge Mathis, I'm telling you, I will leap right, Doyle, I don't want you to put the cuffs on me, because I'll leap right over there and crack her head. I'm telling you.
For what? She ain't done anything.
I am not. She's talking, and you don't talk when I talk. I will not tolerate disrespect on any level.
You do have. I thought you used to be a drama queen.
Bring it down.
I've gotten a lot better.
Yes, I was worse.
But they didn't lock you up.
I never got locked up, Judge Mathis, but
straight
I was
jacket?
Really bad.
Yet.
None of that.
Straight jacket.
Yeah.
None of that.
Yes.
However, I've gotten better because, you know, you live and you learn. With age come wisdom, and I've gotten better.
With age, you have not even accepted
Watch
your age.
Watch out now. She told you what she'd do. Stop it.
She has not accepted the fact.
You give me some background on you all's relationship.
Mathis,
yes, ma'am.
I love my mom. She has tried everything besides a brick and a stick to fight off age, okay? She refuses to accept the fact that she's getting older. She's always trying to.
That
be
is a lie.
And
because listen
top,
to me. Listen, please forgive me. Please forgive me, Judge Mathis. The thing is, yes, I've gotten older, and I'm not by no stretch of the imagination. Am I trying to be young? But I want
That's
to
exactly
feel
why
good.
Her heels
I want to
are
feel good health wise. I want to feel good health wise, and I also want to look great.
That's
but
right.
Nevertheless, I eat healthy and so forth and so on.
And you do. You look great.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you.
Yes, you look great. And a little sexy outfit to make you look even younger.
Oh, my goodness. Well, I had to tone it down,
oh,
you know?
Oh, okay. All right.
I have to, yes.
Okay, because you can't look like a nun and look sexy at the same time. That's a different thing.
Any other day of the week, she'd probably be wearing exactly what I'm wearing in a different color, hoping that I don't notice that she's trying to look just like me. She tries to act like me.
That is a lie. You wish you was half the woman I am today, and I would never wear anything that tight. I do dress in moderation. I will not ever wear a skirt that tight. Maybe in my day. But not now, Judge Mathis. Right. That is a lie. And you think I put that crown on your tooth, I will come over there and pull it off.
Ma'am, why do you keep threatening violence?
You see it, Doyle?
Yes. No,
go
Judge
ahead.
Mathis,
let her
you
speak,
see.
Ma'am. All right, go ahead.
She's always trying to be over the top. She's always wanting to go places with me and wear the same kind of outfits I wear. She's always trying to steal my friends. Like, she's always trying to keep up with the Joneses, and I have to constantly remind her that the Joneses have left you and they're not coming back for you. At all.
That is not true.
You are older, embrace your
age.
There's a problem. This is all good.
True.
My mom being hip and cool and fun.
That
but
is
when
not
my friends start to call my phone and ask me, oh, where's your mom? then we have a problem. Me and my company in my house. She doesn't even knock. She just walks in the door like it's some kind of sitcom.
My goodness.
She is the mother
serious?
That's always
Has
trying
she
to
ever
be
been
up
violent with you? Because she keeps threatening
Never.
You over here.
She
Hopefully
makes a lot
not.
Of threats. And I just don't pet
I
that
do.
Puppy.
What's all this? She just.
See? I don't pet that puppy. She makes me nervous when she starts to threaten me.
Judgment.
She makes me nervous when she. I don't pet that puppy because I don't want to get licked in the mouth. But I do understand that she wants to hold on to her youth. And that's okay, but just don't go so hard like we
what
tried
What do you do
it.
For a living?
I just
Thank
graduated
you.
College.
And drama?
No.
You're a drama
I just graduated
major in what?
Human services. I start my bachelor's this fall. So I basically go to school. That's all right. all I do. I have an 8-year-old son. An 8-year-old son, that might I add, she asks, if I was your age, would you get a girl like me? He's 8.
No.
He's 8 years
that,
old.
Now see, you see she's pointing
Are
on
you
thing.
Serious? She does that to my brother.
Are you
she does
really
that to my
serious,
son.
Kenyatta?
I'm so sincere.
Do you know what?
I am so sincere.
Judge Mathis don't know.
Mathis.
I've been supporting her
Judge
financially the whole 9 yards. I'm the one.
But she's
through
still
the grace
in school,
of God.
Right?
She's
so
in school.
You should
but
help her if
she,
she's in school.
Can you ask her my GPA?
We're going to get to the loan, but how, what, is,
her
what is her GPA?
Her GPA is 3.8.
Wow.
Yes.
Boom.
That is
great.
Boom. Yeah. And I stayed on her constantly.
She did that.
I don't deny. I
well,
love
she has
my
something
daughter.
To do with
dearly.
It.
Absolutely. I don't deny that. I love Kenyatta. All of my children, Kenyatta and I are the closest. That she cannot tell the truth. She tells less the truth or not at
Just
all.
Just get to the loan you're suing her
and
for.
I'm suing Kenyatta for $900. She called me up and she said, Mom, my crown came off. I said, what happened? She said, my crown came off and it just looked bad. I cannot be out and about like this. And I said, but if I step out there like that, you got to pay this money.
What was the repayment plan?
The repayment plan was, my payment was only $50 a month. They went up to $126. And that's when I said, listen, you pay $42. I'll pay $42.
Okay. And how many payments has she missed?
All of them.
Has not paid a dime?
Not a dime.
Young lady?
Okay. I have not paid a dime. No, I haven't paid a dime yet. She just lent me the money. And there wasn't a specific payment plan made from the beginning. She just told me, you're gonna pay this back. Did you tell them why they jumped the payments up? Did you tell them that?
They?
Because she went and got Botox and fillers in her face and expects me to pay for some of
Excuse
her Botox
me?
And fillers.
Excuse me? I'm sorry?
I should not have to pay for Botox because my face is where it's
Oh
supposed
my goodness.
To be.
Listen, check this out.
That's
the
all
thing
I'm saying.
Of it is, again,
That's
I
the
say
point
to
I'm
you.
Trying to make.
Again, I say
That's
to
all
you.
I'm saying.
The last time I checked, that care credit said Vita Peaks, not Kenyatta. And if you establish yourself one day, you'll have the same credit as I, and you won't need me to do this and that and the third for you. Thank you.
You got a good point
now,
there. You
here,
got a good point there.
It was $900.
Let me see
only.
It, please,
I circled it so you can see. Judge Mathis, 10 days before that happened with her, my daughter, she had an emergency. 10 days later, the situation
you
with
do
Kenyatta.
Get, you did get a little bit
I
of
did.
Work over there,
I
man.
Did
you got
a little Judge Mathis,
you
I
got
got
booty
it.
Shots. You got all kind of stuff. Breast implants.
That's not
What you
true.
Getting the shots
no.
for?
Judge Mathis.
That's them young girls
no,
getting them
no,
shots.
No, no, no.
You
not
didn't
true.
Get any shots in your
See,
behind.
No, no. It, look, right here, fillers.
I'm talking about in your behind.
No, not in my behind.
Oh,
that's
that
what
is
this
design.
Thing say.
No. Let's just let you. Let me just let you know.
Had
I want
tux.
My. I do want to do my butt or maybe my breast just the front, cause you know, and I try to tone it up in between. But that just said the fillers right under here. I just got
them,
fillers.
Them, I don't know
she
about them,
fillers,
them shots in the behind.
Next,
you can kind of
no,
tell.
No, no, no.
You don't want that.
No,
you,
no, no. Not just shots.
Shut it off.
No, I want.
She's done it off.
Judge Mathis,
and I heard
want,
they real
no,
stiff.
I just
Judge
want them
Mathis.
To remove.
I heard they
like
real
the,
stiff, too. They
well,
don't feel
know.
Right.
I'd rather have, I just really rather have
I'm
my
a
whole
stiff
be.
Behind.
Judge Mathis,
don't
I prefer
get them
to use
shots.
My
that's
own
That's them little young rappers getting them shots
but
like that.
That
Stop
list
it.
Looks a little bit short. Her
okay,
procedures
but either way it goes,
like Santa's
you
Christmas
could not.
But she can pay for
it.
How about that? She can pay for
them. I'll be able to as soon as I finish college.
And I'm just kidding about the shots, man. I'm just having a little fun with you.
I will be able able to
but
pay
don't
for
get
my
them
stuff
shots,
when I finish
behind shots.
I asked her, I said to Kenyatta, Judge Mathis.
Like
I
the just, woman on TV. You all heard of the woman on TV?
Yeah.
Cement.
There is a medical procedure, approved medical procure that many people get. It costs a few dollars. Mm-hmm. But she was doing it homemade.
That
so injected in the women, and they walk off looking real crazy. So, if you go somewhere, don't go to her. Well, she's in jail.
Judge Mathis.
We're off course. Ma'am, it says you owe 900. Your only defense is what?
Judge Mathis, I just graduated college. I just moved into a house. I have an 8-year-old son.
When did you agree you would begin repaying?
There was no
Yes, it was an agreement.
Statement.
Yes, it was.
She just said,
yes.
I'm not going to do this.
When did you intend to pay?
She told me
quiet.
Yeah, I did.
When did you intend to begin paying?
When she told me the first payment was going to come.
When did she say that would occur?
When she called me and told me about the first payment, I said, wait, hold on. It shouldn't be that much. She said, well, you know, I had my Botox done and, you know.
So she did tell you when the first payment would come, and that is when you intended to begin paying.
Yeah, but she
what is
tried
this
to
defamation you're suing her for? Ma'am, tell me about the defamation.
After she found out that I was suing her, she was telling people loudly that mommy is bugging and I don't know what's wrong with her because you know what? She must be on drugs or something. She must be on drugs or she doing something. She owes somebody some money, but I'm telling you right now, this is not right. And
did
I know.
Did you tell someone that she was on drugs?
I did not say she was on drugs. I said maybe she must owe somebody a lot of money.
Why?
Because it has only, at that time, it had only been 3 weeks.
Okay.
I said, what are you leaning on me right here?
She said she had her girlfriends with her. And
who is Charles?
That's a friend of our family.
Yes.
You all have a good relationship.
Yes.
And he heard
Well, Charles
her,
says...
I'm sorry.
That, yes, I was present at the day of the barbecue. Mrs. Peaks was pretty much announcing to everyone around her, also to whomever she was speaking to over the phone, that her mother, Ms. Vita Peaks, was on drugs and owed people money. Now, this is your friend Charles. You hear what he says? That's why I ask you, were you all still friendly?
He's a friend of the family. Well, maybe not me so much now.
No, I'm not a friend of yours.
I know I would never say that my mom was on drugs. My mom is scared to take an aspirin.
When you were angry with her, you might, as she says, you were angry.
Are you serious?
Charles is serious. Ask Charles if he's serious.
I'm your mother.
Ask Charles
if he's serious. How could you say something like that about me? And thank God that like when I was coming up, the things that she doing, oh no, that was nobody like Judge Mathis and Doyle and people of CPS and ACS and BCS and everybody that keep you off the children. Because whatever our parents said, that's what it was. And let me tell you something, we got beat down. There was nobody, no, you're not gonna play them type of games because they will beat you and talk to you later.
Well, that was what it was.
Respect.
That was
respect
what it was.
Respect is due.
This is what
there
it is.
No,
well, see, and that's
no
why they're talking like
this
you because
totally
this is what it is.
But they
if we could still send you out there
8.
To get them switches, she wouldn't be like that.
They don't have a 3.8.
Get that switch.
They don't have a 3.8 grade point average. Okay?
Get that extension cord.
I do what I have to do.
My mother wouldn't just get the extension cord. She get the whole ironing board.
Can I tell you this briefly?
Yes,
I'm so glad that you said that. Excuse me. I remember my grandmother. I called the police on my grandmother, and when they got there, she said, "ATLL, right? I beat her. And when you leave, I'ma beat her. And I never told on my grandmother again."
I'm just kidding. That was wrong. Parents and grandparents who used to do that, and if they currently do it, I think it's wrong.
Yes.
But it used to happen.
It used to happen.
I think there's other ways of resolving conflict and confrontation with your children and your grandchildren.
I second
because
that
you,
motion.
If you teach them violence as a way of resolving conflict, that's what they're going to think when they go
Absolutely.
To school. They're going to think when you go to school, when you have a disagreement, you engage in violence because that's what my mother did. And
yes.
that's what my grandmother did.
Exactly.
Whenever I had a disagreement with my mother, she hit me. So if I have a disagreement with my classmate, I hit him. So that's the reason we kind of need to back away from that. Find other reasons to do it. You know, put them in the corner and say, Johnny, time out. Yeah, they don't know, you get time out. Just give them time out. Judgment for the plaintiffs in the meantime.
Me and my mom stopped speaking because of this whole thing, and now that it's over, I am gonna pay her, and I just want things to be back the way they used to.
I love my daughter. I love her dearly, but I just want her to know at this point, or she really gonna have to earn that trust that I've had in her for so many years. Let's go forward from here, and let's just let it rest. Okay. I love you.
I love you.
You're a baby.